Thank you very much, and good afternoon. I would like to start my presentation about injected molded zirconia, the most updated technology in implants and restorative dentistry. So I start my presentation with a question: why zirconia? And I'm using zirconia for the last 12 years as a restorative material. And I would like to start with the first question. Why zirconia? So the answer is, this is the strongest ceramic restorative material available today. Okay, so I would like to start with the presentation of a case report. I started in 2004. This patient is a 60 years old healthy woman with a 30 years of experience with a denture. And if you look at the x-ray, this x-ray, you think there is enough bone to do maybe 6 implants or 4 implants. But in the CT scan, you can see in the front area, it's a very, very thin layer of bone, 1, 2, or 3 millimeter. And in the posterior area, it's a pneumatization of the bone. So she doesn't have bone at all. So what you did, and this is with the assistant of this surgery done with Nadi Kaspi. We did iliac crest bone graft and double side sinus elevation. And this is the results after 6 months. You can see from 2 millimeter to 10 millimeter. And then we put 10 implants. And I use here as in the restorative phase, zirconia abutment. It was a long time ago. And also, I use here zircon zang framework by copy milling. Okay, this was the technique then for making zirconia. You could see the copy milling, and this is the results. The patient was very, very pleased because we gave her fixed restoration with zirconia. I split it for 3 bridges, and this is 11 years afterwards. So I have a very good clinical experience with this zirconia. And this patient came to my clinic when I prepared this presentation, and I just asked him to give me permission to take this picture. You can see 3 generations of restoration. The first one is the gold one with the veneering, the PFM, and the new one, 5 years ago, a Pretau. This was the next generation of zirconia. One piece zirconia, occlusion from zirconia on top of the implant. And the results in my clinic is very well. So I use it today for the last 8 years from now. I use exclusively zirconia. That's all. I know there are a lot of other materials, but I use it only this kind of zirconia, very good results. So I would like to express also to this case is 58 years old archaeologist, and he works around the globe in a lot of desert. And you could see what happens to his teeth. Okay, a very, very problematic case, a bruxism. You see a class 3 occlusion. And this is when he opens his mouth. So there is a possibility to do here a root canal treatment and the post and course, but I like the natural teeth. So I did a crown lengthening in the upper jaw and raised the vertical dimension. So you can see in the upper jaw, 6 weeks after the surgery, and in the lower jaw, you can see this is the Pretau zirconia crowns. Very good, very nice, and very healthy tissue. And this is the natural tooth. Okay, in the upper jaw, this is the Pretau. The design is that all the occlusion, the anterior guidance, and also the extrusions to the sides is only on zirconia, not on porcelain. And in the lower jaw, 3 implants in each side. And you can see here, This is the result before and after. And of course, just a clinical tip. I never splint this. I never do bridges in this kind of patients. Only single tooth, okay? So if there is a problem of one breakage of a crown, I would like to have it, to replace it very immediately. And in this bruxism, I gave them just an eye guard, and this is the 6 years follow-up picture. So, why zirconia? The next answer is high aesthetic results. This is two front teeth. You see the very nice aesthetics. Translucency of the pretau is very good. So, you see it's like a natural tooth. And it's very strong material. This is 18 years old girls that come to me to Israel from Houston, Texas. She was in the middle of orthodontic treatment. She missed one teeth, and another teeth is peg shape. So I could do the laminated porcelain. But today I have this zirconia, a very good anesthetic zirconia, so I would like to have something that she will have something for the rest of her life. So this is Tough Dental Silhouette 3.3 implant. And look, after 6 months, she came to me back from Houston, Texas. Look at the bone. No resorption of the bone. And it is not close to the canine. So you see here, there is enough space just because of the angle of the x-ray. So I have a problem. So here you see a very, very minimal preparation. I'm not protruding the tissue. And on the left side, you see the final restoration. It was very problematic. It was about 3 times she goes to the laboratory to fix it because the implant was very problematic. Okay, and you see there a little bit of grayish tissue, and we will talk about it. Okay, but unfortunately, she has a lower lip line. So her mother and hers were very pleased from the results. It is also excellent biocompatibility. The zirconia have excellent biocompatibility. Okay, this is another bruxer. She is a library, work in the library. And another 4 zirconia crowns. And here's the occlusion. It's very, very important to do a very thorough occlusion. And this is before and this is after. And you can see here in the right, it's a problem with the gum. There is a seeding of the gum because of all these retraction cords. But look what happens after 4 years. Okay, excellent biocompatibility. All around materials. The zirconia is all around material. I can use it in the front area. I can use it in the posterior area. I can use it in any finishing line I would like to. This is a periodontally compromised patient. And here I use a feather edge finishing line. I cannot use it in any material, ceramic material. And this is also Zirconzan, 7 years follow-up. Okay, so I cannot do this with the PFM. This is why I'm not using any more PFM in my clinic. I chose 8 years ago, and I don't use PFM anymore. Okay, the last one is a monolithic screw taint restoration. So I cannot do this with other ceramics. And this is, I just don't have enough time, but this is a case I did with Zirconzan Pretau, full mouth screw retained restoration. Okay, so see, this is the patient, PFM. It was very bad planned before with the attachment, but we took it to the operating room in the hospital, and you see what she have below. So the plan was to put 6 implants on each jaw, also with Professor Nadi Kassab, and bone grafting. She wanted immediate loaded provisionals with multi-unit abutment. Okay, so the final restoration, again, zirconia, zirconia pretau, monolithic occlusion, and the occlusion is on the pretau. Very thin porcelain here. Okay? And this is the planning, plastic, white plastic, to check the occlusion. She said this is too long teeth. And she was crying, I don't want this. Okay, so the laboratory prepared another one, and this is the final. And you can see here, very good fit, passive fit. And this is her and her daughter. And a really, really real story, her daughter called me last week. She wanted also to come to treatment. This is after 2 years that her mother is very pleased, okay? So now I'm working exclusively with zirconia. And the question is, why not to work with zirconia implants? Because in Israel, we don't have zirconia implants, and there are more reasons for this. So if I have so many years with zirconia in mouse, with bruxers and all this complicated case, why not to put it as an implant? And the same question was asked a few months ago in Germany. Zirconia oral implants, do we have scientific documentation for general clinical use? And it is, I just want to quote from the article, it is significant in the aesthetic zone in patients with thin and translucent mucosa, exactly as the patient I show you. Okay, it's also for allergy, it's biocompatible, also conductive, and it has no adverse effect on the surrounding tissue. Okay, zirconia has good chemical and dimension stability, high flexural strength, fracture toughness, and good corrosion resistance. The material needs to be manufactured, okay? Manufacturing process has significance for the quality of the final implant material. A different zirconia implant systems may thus have different quality. This is very important. And this is from the article. Okay, another thing is, most zirconia-based oral implants are single-unit implants, one-piece implants. And the placement of the implant is thus essential, and this may be lead to compromised implant positioning. And I don't use one-piece implants. So this is why I'm not using zirconia implants. And so, is it important? Is it important to use zirconia implants? Because most of the dentists, they say, I don't need zirconia implant. I managed to work with the titanium. Okay, so I just want to show you two articles recently published in the Clinical Oral Implant Research about immediate placement and provenization of sinking tooth. This is a group from Denmark. What they did 68 patients, but in the study, only 55 of these patients were included. And this is a representative case. So they put only one case. So what case would you like to publish? You publish the best case you have, okay? So let's look at the case. The right central, B is provisional crown, and C is after three years. I don't want to criticize because I think the result is excellent. And we have a very, very good result here. And the gingiva is excellent, the crown is excellent, everything is excellent. But you see, the gingiva is gray. Okay, so is it important? Because patients can say, this is not important, but it is important. This is also an article published from Mark Hochman, Stephen Cho, and Dennis Terno from Columbia University. You know Dennis Terno. Okay, so they asked this question, is it important? And they divided the patient to high gingival smile line, high gingival smile line, and low gingival smile line. So how many high gingival smile line do you have in your clinic? Do you know? Okay. 28% of your patients are high gingival smile lines. And also they add that the low gingival smile line, 87% show the interdental papilla. So let's go back. Okay, the grayish area is also in the interdental papilla. So it's more than one third of our patients. Another study in the same journal, two very good dentists from München. Okay, immediate implant placement. Munich, München, okay. And they also have only one representative case. They put the best case. It's a very nice case with perfect gingiva, perfect restoration, but you can see the grayish area. I didn't change this, it's just from the article. The gray area around the implant, okay? So in the conclusion, they said, after observation period of 1.5 to 5.5 years, all implants were successful, demonstrating highly satisfactory aesthetic results. Okay, so if the patient is a lawyer or her mother is a lawyer, we are in a problem. So what do you suggest to do here with the gray area? We can do grafting, or we think about something else, maybe a zirconia implant. Okay, so here I want to introduce to you the two-piece innovative zirconia of Tan Dental, which I was involved in the design and the research. And why we call it innovative implants? We have a lot of, if you go around, you see a lot of zirconia implants. Okay, so most of them are one-piece implants, but there are also two-piece implants. So first of all, ceramic injection molding zirconia, this is a technology that we use here to produce the implant. Okay, there is a machining that you take a zirconia and you subtract from this material, and afterwards you sinter the implants. But there is another technique, injection molding, which is used for plastic. But Tough Dental is really have a lot of 40 years of experience with this kind of machines. So they use it to inject ceramic and also zirconia, okay? So it started with the material enter the hopper. The material is melted in the injection unit, because here there is injection unit that is heated, and then it's injected into a mold, and I will show it to you. Okay, so this is the injection molding technique, and the advantages of this technique is controlling the raw material properties. Also, the injection of the melt compound to the mold cavity is without any stress, okay? When you mill the zirconia, you put inside stress. The surface topography can be repeated exactly, so each one of the implants are at 100% the same surface as the previous one. Okay, injection molding has an advantage of creating complicated geometries, and I will show it to you. Okay, so surface surface texture without treatment. This is the surface of the implant. You can see the same, and the metal of the mold is treated, okay, in order to have this texture in the zirconia, okay? So we are not treating the zirconia, we're treating the mold. So the treatment with the mold, we get the roughness of 2.3, and it is incredibly well for zirconia, because it's very difficult to sandblast and acid edge the zirconia. And this is a magnification of 200, 5,000, and 10,000. This is the grain of the zirconia, okay? So here it also confocal microscopy to establish that this is the roughness, and the roughness is very good for zirconia. So the thing is that there is no sandblasting. Remember, no sandblast, no acid edge. The implant goes out from the machine without any treatment. One of the few articles about failure. Most of the companies you go, if you ask them, they don't have any failures. But this is one of the only articles that published about failure. And most of the failure, I think, except one, are 3.3 zirconia implants. So I'm not recommending you to put 3.3 zirconia implants because they're about 10% of breakage after a few years, and according to this article. So they analyzed the fracture. And you can see here the fracture, it's because, and they said it's because the macro design of these implants. And also, you can see here, the crack started from the notch that was generated by the sandblasting of the implant surface. This is analysis of external laboratory. So this is not the not author said this. So you can see the sandblasting is, can cause a fracture. Okay, so we went into preclinical studies. The animal model was minipig pig jaws, maxilla, and mandible. And you see here the mandible, it also, the mini pig chew on it. Also metal chains. Okay, you see, you can see that this is not a digital x-rays. And this is the upper jaw, you can see the ruga. Very nice and very easily insertion, because we used a special drill for this. And this is the results in the upper jaw. Okay, this is a CBCT, and this is the histology. Very, very good osseointegration. Integration. I think better than titanium. Okay, this is in magnification. And this is in the upper jaw. You see, I protrude a little bit the nose. Okay, another advantage of this implant is tissue-level high-polished area. You can see this is the topography of the bone-level zirconia. So with the mold, we can get a very, very high-polished area. And how can I do this? You do it in the mold. And if some of you did a composite with a matrix, you know that always you get the best polished area when you put out the matrix. So if you polish it again and again, you can never get the same polished area. And I presented in the EO in Rome, in vivo, within subject comparison of new injected molded zirconia and titanium implant attachment. So I compare the ZEST locator to a new zirconia locators that Tough Dental produced. And you can see the results after 75 days. The patient brushed the same, exactly right and left. So the zirconia is not antibacterial, but it accumulates much less plaque. This is the father of one of the hygienist girls in our school. And you can see he come to me with the locators. There is no retention at all. I change all the nylons, but it's never helped. So I change it to one zirconia and one titanium. And you see after 75 days, the difference. Okay, so zirconia is much better, especially the molded zirconia, much better than titanium. Wait. So the conclusion of the article was, our findings show that the dentures, especially the non-compliant patients, a zirconia attachment is superior in terms of plaque control, tissue health, and mechanical wear. Okay. Another innovation is the highest insertion torque. Another advantage is the highest insertion torque. Okay. And you can see here, we have a special tool to put the implant, to insert the implant. And you can see very, very nice of the surface, very nice sorry. So the insertion torque, the insertion torque in our laboratory, we check 100 implants up to break test, and out of 100 implants, the average was 140. And the most important number here is the minimum, 120. Most companies suggest you not to insert the zirconia implants more than 35, maximum 40. So we recommend 50 Newton, okay? So if you put the implant in 50 Newton, you have a safety buffer between 60 to 100, okay? So if you want to take it out and you need more power, you have this safety zone, okay? So if you take a zirconia implant and they told you don't put it more than 35, you are in a problem if you're stuck in the middle and you don't know what to do. Okay, so this is very important. And the last one is screw retained. So this zirconia implant is screw retained and is built with a standard hexagon 2.44 and a screw inside. It is very difficult to make this implant with a milling machine, okay? And this is a special coating of the titanium. This is a transfer that if you saw before, I show you here. Okay, no. We have problem with a little bit of gray color of the zirconia. So this coating especially to solve this problem. So this is a transfer, and we have also a PEEK adapter for screw retained restoration. Today in my clinic, I do most of the cases, I do screw retained restoration. Zirconia screwed to the implant. So this PEEK solved this problem. Okay, and this is a screw retained full mouth rehabilitation. I don't think that anyone can show this in the IDS, a screw retained full mouth restoration to zirconia implants. So this is why this implant is innovative. I hope I answered the questions. Okay, thank you very much, and sorry because...